Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Canon has a new camera out, the V10.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Yeah, Canon has a new camera out. It's a little bit different. It's a lot different. The price is $4.29 and maybe change, all right? So it's at Adorama. Or B&H, or maybe the place of your choice, but I will put links to it so you can pre-order it, because the new information is that it's coming out around June 15th to be able to be put into your hot little hands, which is important. And this new camera competes with the phone. Now you can see my screen on here. So let me show you the camera really quick and give you a rundown of what this camera is about. I'm going to go over to the desktop, and now we're on the desktop. So now you can see right on Canon's own website that we have there. The price is $429.99. So if you want to raise the stakes up from your phone, but you still like the phone factor, you like that form, you like it in your pocket, you like it small, you like it thin, but you want a higher quality or more ability than you've got with the phone. So you've got this camera right here. This would be a close-up of it. So it's got a black band across the top, it's got the lens right in the center, and it's got a red action button. It starts and stops. It also comes in black or silver. So that's the silver look. You like the silver look? Well, you get a choice. What can I tell you? I kind of like the black one. All right. So what we've got going here is it's got a built-in stand. So if I come over here and show this to you, okay, you can see from the picture on the left side, I'll bring it in a little closer. See, it's got a stand. Well, that flips out. It's normally up against the body. And see that screen up against the top? Well, that flips out too. It's normally against the body. So it actually gets quite small, like a thin pack of, do I dare say it, cigarettes? That's what it looks like right there, all folded up. So it's got a front side, but it also has a back side. And on the back side, you can actually see the LCD from the back side. And you've got some buttons that you can push. And this is what it looks like with the flippy screen up facing towards you. And let's go back over here. This is the top, okay? So you get two microphone holes, okay? Now they're rather large, which tells me it probably has something, because they really only need pinpoint holes these days for these microphones. It probably has something in there to help you with the wind. But if you do have a wind problem, behold, a small rig is going to be making something you could buy, spend extra money on. Everybody wants you to spend money, all right? That will let you put wind muffins, the little wind muffin things on the top. They'll be magnetic, okay? So let's go back over here where we can actually see. It's got a built-in stand. It's got a 1-inch CMOS sensor, which is a large sensor inside of the camera, which is going to do better in low light than you would expect. Yes, it does have 4K video right here. It's got high quality stereo mics, so both of them are actually active. The one on the left and the one on the right is active, okay? It's got the ease of use UI. Well, that'll be remain to be seen when I get it here. I'll let you know. It's got a 19mm lens, and that's what you get for video, is 19mm. Get my mouth straight. You'll get a 19mm lens that in 35mm talk, it's equivalent to 19mm. So if you look at it, it's going to say 6.6 probably. So it works in the vertical mode, and it also works in the horizontal mode. So the vertical is up and down, horizontal is sideways. So yes, it works in both. So you can record just like a regular camera, or you can record like your cell phone. So let's say you want to go to Instagram or one of the other places where the videos are shown up and down. But like YouTube, it's shown sideways. This covers all of it right there. All right. So it does have face detection. It has stuff built into it to help you with your skin tones, which is important. All right. And one of the things, they're not making a big deal of it right here, but it is a big deal. See right here where it says filters? Okay, I highlight that. So the filters that it has is the funny filters where it makes you do all the different colors and stuff. But it also has ND filters. So if you go outside and you're with your buddies or your friends or your girlfriend, your wife, your kids, whoever you would be outside with, and the sun is very, very bright, okay, it's got built-in ND filters. And it also has on the bottom, it doesn't show me the bottom here, I wish it would, but underneath here on the bottom, it has a tripod screw. So besides the stand where you could stand it up on a desk or something so you can talk right into it like you were looking at your laptop, it has a tripod. So you can actually set this on a tripod, which is excellent. This will also swing all the way down if you wanted it to, the handle I'm referring to, so that you can actually hold it upside down. You can hang it on something and it will rectify it for you in the camera. So what you do also get is over here on the side, you see that hole? You get a USB port, you get a mic jack, you get an HDMI port. So this has got full camera credentials to it, all right? It's got so that, you know, you buy those little cameras and you can do your own higher quality stuff. Well, the phone doesn't have a tripod, so I can't mount this on a tripod. It also doesn't have a handle. I've got to hold it in my handle here. It does not have an HDMI output. It doesn't have a microphone input. So this V10 has all of that. Is this camera going to compete with a $3,000 camera? Come on, guys. You really think it is going to compete with a $2,000 camera? It's going to compete with what we used to call a point-and-shoot, but a little bit better. So it's got built-in image stabilization, but it is digital. It is not going to be like where it's in the lens, but it's not in the lens on the phone either. So what makes this thing quite interesting is the price point. $429, you get a lot of camera features, real camera features, that takes you up above a step of a regular iPhone or an Android phone. And I understand the desire of carrying one of these guys with you is that they are with you. Well, one of these things, $429, you've increased your quality, you've increased your features, you've got an ND filter, you've got the ability to mount it on a tripod and all that stuff that I just mentioned. I'm kind of repeating myself. So it's actually a really good entry point where, let's say you're going like, I'm not sure if I want to get a Sony, a Canon. Nikon's got some cool stuff coming out. What about Panasonic and Fuji and all those other companies? So you're not sure, but you want to get your face online. You want to start actually getting your YouTube channel, your Twitter channel, where they're now doing live broadcasts for you on Twitter, and some of the others. Instagram is coming over with that. Facebook is coming over with that. So you want to get your feet wet, but you don't want to commit to $1,000 right this minute, not because you don't have the money, and maybe you don't, all right, but because you're not sure. What camera do I buy? That's the eternal question. That's the number one question that I get asked here. What camera do I buy? Well, here's an intermediate step on what camera you can start out with. And that's this guy, this booger right here. All right. It's got a lot of the features. It's got the settings that you're used to on cameras, where you got the menus and all that stuff is all built in. You'll see these cameras coming to market and people making reviews. I don't have one in hand yet, and I would like to get one so I can show it to you personally. But the pre-ordering is something very important, because we don't know. Is this thing going to fly off the shelves like pancakes, hotcakes, as they say? Or is it going to be a slow seller? Well, if it's going to be one of those that it's going to be a very hot seller, There's two things you could do. Number one, I will put a link to Adorama, which is an online camera store. I will also put a link to B&H Photo, which is another online camera store. And of course, you've got Amazon, and you could pre-order. So you can get your name on the list. Now, I do know that Adorama doesn't charge your credit card until they actually ship the camera. So I would pre-order if you've got the inkling, because you can actually just back out and cancel your order. The other thing is you can use the link that I'm going to put in the description if you're on YouTube. You can use the link and go over and look at the specs. Look at the pictures up close, where I'm kind of going through it quickly here. I'd rather you be able to go over there and take a look at it. What do they say? In your own leisure. So that is something that I recommend. So that's all I wanted to bring to your attention, is we have a camera that gets packed with some pretty nice features. It's not going to be a $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 camera, but at $429, this is definitely something to look into. You want to go to the beach, but you don't want to take your $2,000, your $4,000 camera? You could throw this in your bag. You could throw this in your pocket. You could throw this in your bathing suit. Might be a little uncomfortable, okay? But if it's got a pocket, you could put it in there. So this camera is trying to bridge that gap between us folks that are doing everything on the phone, but we want to up the quality. We want to up the connection when we want to. Let's say we get into the house and we want to plug it into the computer and we want to go live. We can plug it right from the HDMI output into the computer, have the software that's necessary, and go live, all right? Or it actually has the connections for places like YouTube where you can go live directly, no computer involved. All of that at a price of $429. So this makes this something that is quite important to even know it's out there. So let's say you're a husband and your wife and a wife, and she's going like, we need a camera. And you're going like, well, use your phone. Well, you have a really nice camera. Why can't I use the camera? Well, you're going, well, because you don't know how. And you won't let me teach you. Well, $429, she can have her own camera. You got teenagers, or you got something where you can't afford to lose your expensive camera. We now have a very interesting choice on the horizon. June 15th is the shipping date. It's already been announced. I just showed you the Canon website. So go to the links below, click on the Adorama link, put your name on to pre-order the camera right there, okay? And it'll put you on the list. And that's what I wanted to share, something really important that people should know, even if they're not in the market. Because people like me have lots of cameras, and I'll get something like, can I borrow your camera, dude? Well, inside I'm going, no, you can't. Hello, can you afford to replace that camera? So this would be a camera for me to carry around. And can I borrow a camera, dude? Yeah, here, have at it. All right, and if it breaks, you owe me $429, not $3,000, not $2,000. All right, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.